Ticket to play for the NBA title awaits the winner. Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals on EA Sports. We're at Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Tonight, the Brooklyn Nets taking on the Atlanta Hawks. Hi, everyone. With Jay Williams, I'm Ed Cohen. Jay, you talk about the Nets coming in. They have the home court here, always crucial in Game 7, with the winner moving on to the NBA Finals.
Now look, I think both teams are worthy of going to the NBA Finals. But the reality is that only one team will prevail this evening. And the way this series has gone so far, I wouldn't be surprised if it goes all the way down to the final shot.
Russell with it up top. He'll run the offense. Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say no foul.
In the paint, you need to finish. Just like that.
Count the basket at the rim.
I don't think these kind of shots are tough for Trae Young. You see, he's always been the smallest guy on the court, so he's had to finish through the trees. He's a lot tougher than he gets credit for.
Alex Len sends it away.
That kid can block out the sun, man.
From long range, great feed sets it up. Yes. And the foul, and a chance at three coming up.
And if you have the ball in your hands on offense and you're that open and you see the defense sprinting at you, directly at you, not taking an angle to try to block your shot to not hit you, brace yourself for contact, focus on making the basket, and one every time.
Free throw's good. A three-point play. And with that, they go up by three. Russell into the front court, just getting started. Strap in for a good one here in Game 7. Yes, D'Angelo Russell missed his first. That one goes.
That's what I'm talking about, Ed. It's that simple. Put the ball in the bucket.
Beyond the arc for three. His first effort off the mark. Russell with it up top. Down a point. Nice pass to set things up.
I love the drive to the basket there. Instead of trying to go around or over, go through.
Layup's good. Those are the types of shots you always strive for.
You see, here's why versatility is so imperative for your offensive repertoire. If you're a one-trick pony as a defender, I know exactly how to defend you because you only do one thing. But if you have versatility, then the coach can put you in multiple looks within the offense, and then you can get it any way you want.
That's off the side of the rim, short.
Shoot or shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
Russell, defended by Lynch. Can't do that.
Just a tic-tac foul.
Russell. A shot no good by Harris. Count the basket.
And attention to detail is everything for a professional scorer like that. Actually getting it done the hard way.
Russell, into the front court. They're down three. And watch him do the rest. Slam dunk. Good luck keeping up with that.
Did you see that jump? It was as quick as a pogo stick.
Finishing inside the paint on that one.
No doubt about where that one was headed.
Russell with it up top. Down three. Here comes the screen. Harris picked up by Lamb. Oh, whistle.
Timing was just a tad bit off.
And a whistle.
Ed, you can't lunge like that. First one, counted. And he makes the move. Trae Young doesn't have the touch. No good. Basket's good on the follow. Way to stay with it. Russell into the front court. Less than a minute to go in a tightly played first quarter. A chance from long range. That's off the side of the rim. No good.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack it to the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Short jumper won't fall. On the follow. Way to stay with it.
Bodies bouncing all around on that layup with the offense winning that battle. But if the defense keeps up that kind of pressure, good things are bound to happen.
He gets it.
Well, look, you can't be caught flat-footed on defense. You need to be on the balls of your feet, especially in transition. You have to jab at that guy with the ball, hedge at him, make him think that maybe you will take him, maybe you'll fan out to a defender on the perimeter, but still keep him guessing. But when you don't do that, that's easy money.
They'll let one fly from half court. That misses with a second to go. One quarter down in... Ed Cohen, Jay Williams with you as we get things started here in the second quarter. Oh, the whistle. Jay, take your hands off of me.
That's just a blatant foul. Maybe he's trying to make a statement.
Alex Lynn, huge block. They've recovered it. Usually one that he'll knock down and scores.
There's certain guys in this league that should be put on alert status 24/7 because either they're posterizing you or that attempt can still be a poster.
And they call it.
Welcome to New Age basketball. You blow on me, that's a foul.
Knocked loose. Calls out of bounds. Last touch by Damari Carroll. Go.
The most important thing a shooter can do is continue to shoot. The defense is always going to give great effort, but it's more of your psyche that goes into the next shot that will limit you on whether you make the shot or not.
Lays it up and in. Now the Nets going to take a timeout as they'll take a moment to go over things here in the second quarter.
So far. Off the mark on the first free throw.
Oh,
he missed them both. To Trae Young. Gets a look. Can't hit.
I'm not sure if the contest on the shot contributed to the miss, but what it might have done is seep into the confidence of the shooter at the next...
Oh! Out there looking like the Kimbe Mutombo. Took it right to him, and the defender was ready. Hawks recover. Cruises inside for two.
Head sometimes less is more. Keeping it simple is the best way.
Nets have the basketball. Alex Len, a tip chip. And that one out of bounds off a net. Trae Young. Trying to cash in. The shot by Len. No good. The follow won't go either. Russell with it up top. Trailing by 11. 4-3. Too good to leave that wide open. D'Angelo Russell hits.
Ooh, that confidence level was so superior. Whenever you start jogging back on defense before the ball even goes through the net, that speaks for itself.
Russell to the front court. Down 8. John Collins snatching it out of the air. Out of bounds the call. Last touch by D'Angelo Russell. End score. Strong take.
It looks like he's using his ball handling to feel the game out. I know it looks like he's just playing around out there trying to get the fans going. That is true, but he's also finding his rhythm.
Russell. Knocked loose. And that one out of bounds off a net. Going to launch beyond the arc. And he still can't find his range from deep. It's no good. Russell with it up top. Trailing by 10. Missed it. Almost a foul. They let it go. Let's it fly from long range. Can't connect. To Russell. Over to the right side. Fires the three, buries it on the catch and shoot.
And let me tell you how this one goes. It ain't no fun, but the homies can have some. Everyone's getting a piece of the rock tonight.
Has a chance. Off the mark. Well contested.
You know, Ed, everybody gives so much credit to the guy who contested the shot, but there's no way he's in that position without the communication of the backbone of the defense. When you have a guy back there who can block shots and tells you to apply more pressure, you know you're in a safe place.
Cleans it up, and a put-back slam.
Ed, it's pretty amazing how athletic bigs can be when it comes to getting an easy 2 points, huh?
Russell, into the front court. They trail by 7. Oh, a whistle.
He took a chance. That's the right call.
Russell. Alex Len swats it. That'll be out of bounds. Last touch by a Hawk. Russell. Yes, D'Angelo Russell. He's 3 for 7.
D'Lo reminds me so much of Sam Cassell. He's not the fastest guy, but he gets where he wants to go anytime. The word that is key for him, potential, potential, potential. Will he be able to accomplish his potential?
Just inside the arc, at the buzzer, we are at halftime in Game 7. Let's get you to Orlando, where we say hello to Jalen Rose in our EA Sports Halftime Report.
The Hawks. Thanks for joining us for the halftime report. The second half is about to be started.
Brooklyn with the basketball. Wide open look won't go. for three. Can't connect. It's no good. And the rebound taken in by Lynn. Stuffs it down with authority.
An easy two. Get back on defense.
Oh, they called a foul.
Those cat-like hands almost got a steal.
Knocked loose. That'll be out of bounds. Last touch by a Hawk. So the Nets hold on to the possession. Passed it off.
He sent that one to the third row.
He was locked in. That was impressive. Goes to the left side. Lets it fly from beyond the arc. No good. To Trae Young. Fires the three. Trae Young bobbing just enough there.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get the offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
It's Brooklyn's ball. Russell. Big finish at the rim. Jay, let's see if that's a sign for him.
Well, he's been pretty much non-existent the first three quarters. But when you have a play like that, that can get the juices going, and that can help you with your offensive rhythm.
Russell with it up top. His guy's down by nine. It's a big finish. Here on the home floor, they're chipping away.
I mean, does this crowd have a pulse? Are they even alive? Sometimes when you make a play like that, your crowd needs to get you back in this ballgame.
Deep right corner, D'Angelo Russell. That's off the side of the rim, short. And a nice finish at the rim.
Oh, man, you're not supposed to be able to do that with that size, but in today's game, dexterity and mobility are off the charts for bigs.
Almost unlucky bounce. Too much contact, and free throws coming.
And as a defender, you cannot, I repeat, you cannot foul in the act of upward motion into your shot. Your timing needs to be better.
John Collins, he's got two shots coming, hasn't missed yet. Knocks down the first. Two for two on that trip. Russell into the front court. His guy's down 11. Terrific vision. Oh, the monster stuff.
And when you get your prescription, you take your medicine and you call it a day.
Nothing going here on that drive. He was smothered and still gets it to go down.
And the true test of a team's character is how they respond when they get hit in the mouth. Keep digging.
Russell. From long range. Not getting the bounce. Beyond the arc for three. Off the iron. No good. Russell with it up top. Down 11. Here comes the screen. There it is. Sixth foul. He's on the bench for the rest of this game.
Simple touch foul.
Coach has seen enough. He wants some changes. New personnel onto the floor. Hawks come up with it. To Carter. Here's a chance from long range. Vince Carter 20 years ago, maybe. Not that time.
Shoot or shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
Has a look. Off the mark. What on earth was he thinking?
and is never a great thing when you're talking to yourself the entire next possession about the shot you just missed. Now you know you're in that player's head mentally.
That ends the third quarter. The Hawks with the lead. Hawks with the basketball to start this fourth quarter. They had the lead coming out of halftime. They were able to extend that lead in the third quarter.
A lot of fans and players get consumed with the big plays, but the coaches love seeing their teams continuing to do the little things. That's how you increase the lead.
Mitch Abbott. Knocked loose. Calls out of bounds. Off Kent Bazemore.
Maybe he's trying to make a statement.
John Collins with a piece.
Sent a message on that one, Ed.
Auto shot misses to Russell. Kent Bazemore knocked away. It's getting dangerous down there.
And I hated getting my shot blocked like that, but I did like getting the ball right back.
Off the assist.
It's really a dope thing when passing becomes infectious. But don't become overly passive. Still take your shots when they're there.
4-3. That's not his range. It's no good. Russell, into the front court. 9-point margin. Alex Lynn rejects it.
Don't stare him down like that afterwards.
Count the bucket for two.
Strong finish. That's what you need, regardless of contact, focusing on the rim.
Brooklyn's got it. And too much contact.
That's just a blatant foul. Maybe he's trying to make a statement.
And a whistle.
Timing was just a tad bit off.
And they call it.
Just a tic-tac foul.
Alex Lynn pins it.
That kid can block out the sun, man.
No good. So Russell. Great dish to set it up. Count the basket. Two more points in the paint.
And that may not have been a gimme, but that layup at the rim definitely chips away at the pride of the defense.
Stuffs it down with authority.
It's easy to become mesmerized when you watch a player who can create off the dribble. We call that dancing. When you allow a player to dance with that much space, that's Prob City.
It's good. If you don't stand in his way, he's going to make you pay.
When the ball's in his hands, we all knew what was going to happen.
Going to launch beyond the arc. Russell with it up top. His team down 9. Shot from the lane. Won't go. Two there, won't go.
We call some of these players practice players. You know the guys that make 5 out of 10 shots in practice, but then all of a sudden they're not gamers because then they're making 1 of 10. That's exactly what you want him to do. You want him to take those kind of shots.
Count it. No and one. There was some contact there.
Okay. You don't get a 10 for style points, but it worked.
Yes, and a foul. He'll have a chance of a 3-point play.
And so many players, when they come into the paint, they come in with that soft approach. He didn't come in soft at all. He came in with aggression, and he went through the defender. Through, not around. That's key.
Free throw is good. It's a 3-point play, and that just might put this game out of reach. Nets have the basketball. Jay, he commands the paint this time down. Hey, look,
Pretty dudes can mix it up once in a while, too, I guess.
Let's it fly from long range. Second effort. On the follow. Way to stay with it.
In the paint, you need to finish. Just like that.
Russell, into the front court. His guys trail by 10. No good. Oh, looked like he may have gotten there. And the reward is going to the line.
I don't know about that one, Ed. I always thought your hand was part of the ball.
D'Angelo Russell at the line for two shots. Shooting 50%. Some yes, some no in this contest. Second one's good. Splits the pair. Fires the three. He was all over. To Russell. For three. That's off the side of the rim. No good. To Carter. Not that time.
Oh, I see how you're playing this chess match. That's what you keep doing defensively. Keep baiting him and luring him into shooting that jump shot. Exploit
it. Let's it fly from beyond the arc. It's good. Coach wants to see more from his D.
I know he's a volume shooter. I know defensively at times you have to take your lumps. Might be time to adjust the scouting report, though. Start denying him the ball.
Basket's good on the follow. Way to stay with it.
That's a strong finish. Regardless of contact, finishing strong is key.
Fires the three. Oh, he hits the three.
Just because someone is listening to you doesn't mean that they actually hear you. At the end of the game, when players get tired, they listen to what the assignment was, but then you hear what it was.
And hits the first free throw. Goes two for two. Inside the arc, at the buzzer, just off the mark. The Hawks are victorious. They stand alone atop the Eastern Conference, on their way to the NBA Finals. For my partner Jay Williams and our entire crew, I'm Ed Cohen. This has been the NBA Playoffs on EA Sports. Find out more at easports.com. Until next time, good night.
Reason to celebrate right now. On behalf of Ed Cohen and Jay Williams.